Hey y'all, Melissa here with you today, and today I want to share my 5 favorite tips for more sustainable sewing. If you know anything about fast fashion and the impact that all that textile waste has on the environment, you might be concerned with how you can use your sewing practice to combat fast fashion, because one of the opposites of fast fashion is slow sewing and making your own. But even when you're sewing your own things, there are ways to be more environmentally conscious. So I'm gonna talk about 5 of them today. Tip number 1, learn how to mend. So this is an old, like decades old pair of jeans, and the denim kind of stretched out as my body grew, and so they still fit and I still love to wear them. As you can see though, they've been heavily mended. If I had just thrown these away when they first got holes that became kind of indecent if I was wearing them with that many holes, I wouldn't have what is now one of my favorite and most comfortable pair of jeans. So I've used 2 different types of mending on here. One is by machine and one is by hand. And I've got tutorials to both of these types of mending linked below. So you might want to check that out. And as you can see, you can combine different mending methods on the same garment and then still wear it and make it usable and keep it out of the landfill, particularly if it's a pair of jeans that fits just right, because those are hard to come by. Tip number 2, seek out reuse centers. A lot of big cities, Austin included, have centers where they recycle creative materials. So in Austin currently, we have Austin Creative Reuse, and it is a resale shop and it's only like art and craft supplies. So for example, there I got yards and yards of this lovely sheer cotton fabric with this kind of vintage print on it. I think I paid maybe $3 for something like 6 or 7 yards of this. I've used it in all kinds of different things, and as you can see, I still have more that I can use. So if you have something like that, or if you have a thrift store that accepts fabric donations, then that's a great first place to go look for materials, because you never know what you're going to find, and it's often extremely affordable. Tip number 3. Shop thrift stores for fabric, even if it's coming from clothing. So you can totally take clothing and just cut it apart and use it as the supplies for your projects. You can use it to make other clothes, and that's a really great way to get apparel quality fabrics if you don't have a nearby store to shop the fabrics. Some of the things you want to look for if you're thrifting clothing to upcycle or to use as fabric sources. First of all, this is a great piece that I found recently, and I'm gonna tell you why it's a great piece. It has, you can see, no darts, and it only has the side seams and then the shoulder and sleeve seams on it. The fewer seams that your garment that you wanna thrift to use as fabric has, the more usable fabric you will have. If you have seams already, you either have to incorporate those seams into your design or cut around them. So with this particular one, where I only have those side seams to worry about, and have a lot of usable fabric that is in, you know, a continuous piece unbroken by seams. Another great thing about this one, it's super long. This is actually a floor length dress, and not only is it floor length, it's 2 layers. So the top layer is about knee length and the bottom layer goes down to floor length. So I got double the fabric in this. And then I got it at 50% off day at the thrift store. So I'm having lots of fun thinking about what do I want to do with all of this fabric. It doesn't have to be a dress. Like, you can cut it apart, make it skirts and a skirt and a top, or you can make shorts, or just treat it like fabric and then look at the amount you have and if it's enough to make whatever you're thinking of. Another good thing I like to do at the thrift store is to look for old graphic t-shirts. A lot of times they've been washed so many times, they're nice and soft, and you can really see how the fabric's gonna wear. I mean, if it was gonna get all pilled up, you would know it because it would have done it already. So I like to do things like buy men's t-shirts a lot of times because they're bigger and it gives you more fabric to work with. And then do things like this tank top was made out of an old t-shirt. I just added the contrasting trim and used the t-shirt to like cut out my tank top. That is one thing to do. You can also just take big t-shirts, and another great project for them is to turn those into raglan style t-shirts. You might not have enough fabric to cut out like a whole front and back and sleeves, but you can probably cut out just the front and back and then add contrast raglan sleeves, and that's another fun way to upcycle t-shirts. So I actually have a couple of those. That's also a good way if there are stains like near seams of the t-shirts, you can easily cut around those if you're doing something like a raglan style t-shirt. Tip number four, check out antique stores and estate sales as well, and don't just look at clothing items as potential things to upcycle, also look at linens. So this circle skirt, and I actually have a tutorial for how I made this, but this came from tablecloth lace. It was a round tablecloth, so pretty much all I had to do was cut out the center and attach the elastic, and this has become one of my favorite circle skirts to wear. It is see-through, so I can wear leggings under it, or I can put another slip or a skirt under it, and depending on what I put under it too, that gives it a little bit of a different look. If I wear long leggings in the winter, it's a lot warmer than if maybe I put on like shorts in the summer, and that's a totally different look. Another thing I love to look for at estate sales and antique stores is sheets. A lot of vintage sheets have great prints on them and they can be really soft. So I actually have a link to a couple of videos below about pajama shorts and a pajama top that I made out of old bed sheets. Tip number five, use up your scraps. As a pattern designer, I use a lot of muslin fabric, and one of the things I like to do, and I have a link below to how I do this, but I like to use up my muslin scraps and I make not paper towels, but we keep these in a jar on our counter and we use them instead of paper towels. They're easy to wash, and then that uses up the fabric more before it gets thrown away. I have so many of these that I have started making gift sets of them for family members and friends who maybe don't sew but would be happy to swap out their paper towels for reusable cloth towels. And because it's just muslin and because they're just being used to wipe up messes, I can kind of make them any size that I want. I also do this with old clothing sometimes. When it wears out to where I can't really cut anything else out of it clothing wise, I can turn it into rags, because if it's got stains on it that I might not want to wear, nobody's going to care if it's something that I'm just using to wipe up spills and messes. So that's another great way to take fabric that otherwise might have gotten thrown away and give it more use. Ultimately, the more fabric can be used before it is discarded, the better for our landfills. Hopefully you have found these five different tips helpful, and make sure that you check out the other sustainable sewing projects that I've been sharing this month.